And now we will finally learn the last part of proving your entire set of QuickBooks Desktop records are correct to the last detail. The last part is fixing expense account classification. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Choosing the wrong expense or asset when recording a check or bill is the only type of mistake that cannot be found and fixed by comparing your records to an independent source. Now, the IRS knows very well that the vendor will not check our own records to see which expense classification is in our own records for the check that we just gave the vendor. Therefore, the IRS knows that the expense category is not checked by an independent source and could be wrong. And we all know that the expense category determines whether the expense is deductible or not. So it is our own responsibility to make sure it's correct so that we don't get in trouble. So how do you find any checks, expenses, or vendor bills with this mistake? Well, we start with what works for 90% of these transactions. It's called the one vendor, one expense rule. This rule asserts that about 90% of the time, each vendor will have only one expense in their transactions. Conversely, about 90% of the time, each expense will always have the same vendor or vendors recorded in the transactions for that expense. For example, UPS and FedEx will always be delivery expense. They will never repair our equipment. Therefore, if we see a check or bill payable to UPS and we see repair expense in the category field, we know it's a mistake. Conversely, Reese's Repair Ranch will always be repair expense in every transaction that we record with Reese. She will never deliver a package for us. Therefore, if we see a check or bill payable to Risa and we see delivery expense in the category field, we know it's a mistake. So, what's the solution? Well, solution step one, we will run reports that show vendor name by expense. We will easily compare the vendor names to the expense category. We will open and examine anything that we're not sure of when we run this report. In this case, we will use the trial balance and open each expense and asset. We will observe the vendor name in each account. And then I, Mark, your teacher, actually planted two mistakes. And let's see how difficult or easy it is to find using this method. After downloading the sample file and logging in with the credentials that were provided in the description of this video, we can click the shortcut to open the trial balance. Notice it's showing us the results of all transactions regardless of date. Now, we don't know if these expense amounts are correct. The only way to find out is to double-click and open them up. For example, electricity or electric expense. If we double click this number, we should see only the name Con Edison in the name field. That's because in New York, where we are, Con Edison is the only vendor that provides electricity. So it should stand out very clearly that there's a name here that does not belong. We know Verizon does not give us the electric service, so that's the check we should double-click, go back to the actual check, the hard copy itself, and we should take a look and find out if this is correct. And if not, we should change the expense to what the expense is supposed to be for that particular check for Verizon. It's the same thing with telephone expense. If we double-click telephone expense, we should see the name only Verizon. We should not see Con Edison because they provide electricity. So that's the one that we should double-click and go back to the original source, April 13th for $1,300. Take a look at that Con Edison check and see if it's correct, and whatever's wrong, we can fix it right here. So that would be one way of finding and fixing misapplied expense checks. The other method that will reveal these types of mistakes will be to run reports that show expense by vendor name. You can easily compare the vendor names to the expense category on this report. Then you can open and examine anything you're not sure of. To do this, we will use the transaction list by vendor report. Then we will customize the report to show the split account, because the split account is actually the expense or the asset that goes with the vendor transaction. Then we will observe the expense name in each vendor's section. You will see the same mistakes that I, Mark, your teacher, planted there. When searching for misapplied expense categories by vendor, the best report to do that is this one, Transaction List by Vendor. And you can see all of the checks to Con Edison say electric expense except this one. This one stands out as telephone expense. So now we'll go ahead and fix it. It's the same one we saw a moment ago. Double click. $1,300, April 17th, and we know that we should change it to electric expense. And then we'll click Save and Close, and now the expense category is correct. If we scroll all the way down to Verizon, we can see that Verizon has every check made out for telephone expense except this one. This one on February 10th, the person who wrote it accidentally put electric expense. So we double click and we change it to what it's supposed to be. Save and close. Yes. Now the report clearly shows every check to this particular vendor is the same expense, and that's the way it should be. And the final issue that always comes up when reclassifying transactions, what if you made the same mistake on many bills and many checks? Well, the solution is something called the Accountant's Toolbox. Inside the Accountant's Toolbox is a tool called Reclassify Transactions. Unfortunately, it's only available in the Accountant's Edition or if you log in as the Accountant user. Fortunately, most of our students are actually using the Accountant's Edition, so I can show you exactly how this works. The file we're using was made with the Accountant's Edition, and you are logged in as the Accountant user if you used the username and password that were provided in the description. So we can open this tool and fix things, but first, let's identify the problem. When I open the trial balance, I open the account called Supplies, and I double-click. And I stretch the column of name open a little bit more so that we can look closely at those whom we've purchased supplies from. Now, Staples, that looks good. Makes sense that we purchase supplies from Staples. Okay, now, what about Donna's Office Supplies? Well, it makes sense that we would buy office supplies from a company named Donna's Office Supplies, but look closely. There's another vendor with a very similar name, Donna and Dan Delivery. So it doesn't really make sense that we would pay a company named Donna and Dan Delivery to purchase office supplies from. It is more likely, because these two names are very similar, it is more likely that Donna and Dan Delivery, we were paying a delivery and not buying office supplies. But notice it happens several times because the name is so similar. Donna's Office Supplies, Donna and Dan Delivery. And if you know anything about your business, you know that delivery expense and deliveries are not only made by UPS. So if you know in your own business that deliveries are not only made by UPS, but you open delivery expense and you only see UPS, you know there's a problem. And when you look at the supplies account, you see the explanation of the problem. What probably happened was whenever you wrote a check for office supplies for Donna and Dan, well, whenever you wrote a delivery, a check for delivery, you accidentally put supplies and the names were similar. So since there is many, many, many of them, it would take a long time to double click, change the account, and go to the next one. So let's use that special accountant's tool. We click accountant and we go down to client data review, and the specific part of client data review, we will click reclassify transactions. And now we have the reclassify transaction tool. Now, we can change the date, and you should immediately put the date range because that's what everything is based on here in this tool. So the first thing you will do is change the date to make sure you're including all of the transactions within the top date range. Notice you can see all four expense accounts show up here, and all I have to do is click on one of them, and I'll see all the transactions within this date range for that particular expense. Now, if you want to fix supplies, you can't limit it to only expenses. You would have to change it to balance sheet accounts because we classified supplies as an asset rather than an expense. So I click supplies and notice you can see all the transactions that were recorded in the supplies account between this date range. And the ones we want to reclassify are the ones that say Donna and Dan Delivery. We don't want them here. We want them instead to be in delivery expense. So from the pull down, we choose Donna and Dan Delivery, and now we will see only the transactions in the supplies account who have the name with the vendor Donna and Dan Delivery. Now, all of these need to be taken out of supplies and put into delivery expense. And now that we've identified them, we can click select all and then simply tell QuickBooks which expense account they should be in. And in this case, it's delivery expense. And when I click the reclassify button, all of the transactions that were wrongfully put in supplies have been properly reclassified to the delivery expense account. And to prove it, when I open the trial balance, the supplies number is much smaller and the delivery expense account is much bigger. And when I double click the supplies, you see I bought only from Staples and only from Donna's Office Supplies, which makes more sense. And now when I double click the delivery expense account, I see that we get deliveries from Donna and Dan's Delivery as well as UPS. Now you may well ask, what about a vendor we purchase different things from? Staples is our example for a vendor with multiple accounts in their transactions. We sometimes buy supplies from Staples and we sometimes buy equipment from Staples. So what do we do? Well, in this rare case, if a small number of transactions are in the vendor or in the vendor section, we should check the attached source documents of each one, because if there aren't that many, it won't take that long to check. If there are many, then what we should do is find another data field in the transaction that may indicate which expense or asset is being purchased. For example, if equipment purchased are usually thousands of dollars and supplies purchased are usually less than $100 each purchase, then we could simply use the money amount to judge whether we put the correct expense account before we open it up and actually look at the source document. You will know what may identify the correct category in your own company. If you know how your company runs, there will always be something in the transaction that will tell you, is this supposed to be one expense or the other? And if you're not sure, you can always open it up and look. So if you know a little bit about your business, you know that you purchase both supplies and equipment from Staples. Now, when I double-click equipment, you see that it's no problem and every vendor is Staples. Now, we fixed the vendor, but we did not necessarily fix all of the categories if you buy several different assets or expenses from the same vendor. We double-click supplies. Now, we know that they're all correct as far as the vendor, but what we don't know is if some of these are for equipment. For example, look at this, $4,300. Or, well, let's really focus on Staples. In fact, let's imagine that we only buy office supplies from Donna, but we know when it comes to Staples, we sometimes buy equipment and sometimes buy supplies. So let's filter out Donna so that we can focus on Staples. Click the custom report, and then we're going to filter by name, type N for name, and choose only Staples, and then click OK. Now we have the same report, but only for Staples. We don't want Donna because we know already that we only buy supplies from her. But we want Staples because we want to take a closer look at some of the transactions to make sure that these are actually supplies and not equipment. So the first thing we would do is double-click the one with the highest money amount. And we would go and take a look at check number 8, and we would find any kind of receipt or bill that went along with check number 8. Maybe an attachment that explained what it was. Because we have to verify, did we buy supplies or did we buy equipment? So the fact that the money amount was much, much higher than any of the other supply purchases from Staples indicates that that is possibly classified wrong.